Galileo Galilei is best known for his astronomical discoveries with the telescope, but equally important were his experiments and discoveries in mechanics, the physics of moving bodies. This work, completed late in Galileo's life, was one of the foundations that Isaac Newton, working a generation later, was to use to build his great synthesis that culminated in the three laws of motion and the law of universal gravitation. In this demonstration, we will be exploring one of Galileo's important discoveries about the behavior of massive bodies freely falling in a gravitational field. To Galileo's contemporaries, the behavior of a massive body is very easy to understand. It's made of the Earth, and just like Aristotle told them 2,000 years before in his great work, The Physics, because an object is made of the Earth, if we drop it from a height, it is following its natural tendency to settle down into the rest of the mass of the Earth. Furthermore, the heavier an object, the greater that impetus to fall to the ground. So a heavy object, like this 2-kilogram hammer, should actually fall faster than this 0.5-kilogram hammer. If I were to hold the hammer and drop it, the speed with which it falls depends upon how much mass there is. But is this true? Galileo tested this assertion in a series of very simple experiments. We're going to do those experiments here using the same pair of hammers. This one weighs 2 kilograms, this one weighs 0.5 kilogram, so the mass ratio is 4:1. I'll give myself a little height here. I'm going to hold them up and drop them at the same time. Aristotle would predict that the heavier hammer would fall the fastest and hit the ground first, and the lighter hammer following shortly behind. But what really happens? Let's not rely on the words of Aristotle. Let's do what Galileo did and do the experiment. 2 kilograms, 0.5 kilogram, 4:1 mass ratio. Which one will hit the ground first? The heavier one, according to Aristotle, or something else? Let's see. They both hit the ground at exactly the same time. Now you might argue 4:1 isn't big enough. Well, let's go bigger than 4:1. Let's go 75:1. 1 kilogram and 75 times less. Appropriately, a little moon ball. And we'll drop them. They hit the ground at the same time. What if we go even lighter? Well, let's go to a ratio of 4,000:1. This turkey feather weighs 0.5 gram, 4,000 times less than the hammer. What's going to happen when I drop them together? Behave differently. Why? Because the feather is so light that air resistance played an important role. I would like to be able to drop a hammer and a feather, but without the role of air resistance. We can't do that easily on Earth, but Galileo could imagine a place where there was no air and do the experiment as a thought experiment. But we don't have to just do it as a thought experiment. In 1971, astronaut Scott did it from the moon at Apollo 15.
Well, in my left hand, I have a feather. In my right hand, a hammer. I guess one of the reasons we got here today was because of a gentleman named Galileo a long time ago who made a rather significant discovery about falling objects in gravity fields. And we thought that where would be a better place to confirm his findings than on the moon. And so we thought we'd try it here for you. The feather happens to be appropriately a falcon feather for our falcon. And I'll drop the two of them here and hopefully they'll hit the ground at the same time. How about that?
How about that?
Which proves that Mr. Galileo was correct in his findings.